Greg, in terms of personnel, not exactly the matchups we were expecting to see tonight.
You know, again, with all the injuries and some guys now having to step into unfamiliar roles, in some ways that makes tonight all the more intriguing to see which guys are going to step up and deliver.
And now the Lakers starting group. Markieff Morris is out there with Andre Drummond. Then there's Kyle Kuzma. Then it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, and it's Schroeder in at the point. Fox passes to Holmes. Back to Fox. Healed outside. Six on the shot clock. Holmes has a screen. The offensive rebound.
Oh, how about the finesse there? Nice little gentle touch on the board.
And you know, when you have that gentle touch, those tip-ins are easy to come by. Now, here's Schroeder. He isn't playing a big part of their offensive scheme, averaging around 15 and a half points a game. And here's Heald. He'll bring it up for the Kings. Their last game, a win against San Antonio, looking to carry that into this one.
Yeah, in that game, I thought they took advantage of some sloppy play, but give them credit. They turned mistakes into points.
Yeah, the last game, it felt like they were just feeding off of what they were doing defensively, forcing a lot of those turnovers, and that helps build your defensive confidence.
Now Caldwell Pope after the missed three from Buddy Hield. And the powerful one-handed slam.
Really most effective when he's in attack mode, and KCP with the athleticism to do it.
For Sacramento, they've gone just 1-4 to get this game started. On the wing, Barnes. Pass to Halliburton. Three-pointer, Heal. Up and in, it's good. First basket of the game for him. 1-for-4 shooting.
And you love how Heald is always ready with his feet set. Once the ball hits his hands, it's off.
Kuzma against Heald. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Luke Walton gave me a few minutes to catch up with him. Big man and big problems tonight with Andre Drummond on the other side. Coach told me that they can't depend on one player keeping Drummond off the glass. It's going to take a group effort on the boards. They know the task that they face, and it's a big one. Guys?
Thanks, David. Here's Schroeder after the basket by De'Aaron Fox. Here's Drummond. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And you look at the size and athleticism. Once Drummond gets the ball in there, it's game over.
Los Angeles shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good.
And at last season's trade deadline, Andre Drummond traded away basically for a second round pick, a shockingly low return for a guy who was once considered a franchise player.
And both free throws good for Drummond. And Greg, why is it that the Pistons got so little in exchange for Drummond?
Well, I think he was an impending free agent. I think Detroit looking to rebuild. Also, it says something about the center position in today's game.
Now, here's Kuzma. Harrison Barnes missing his lunch. To the middle. Here's Drummond. Easy jumper from very short distance.
A tall and powerful big. Drummond has a natural ability to finish inside.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Three-pointer, Heal. Morris with the rebound.
Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Schroeder finds Drummond. He goes up again. And finally, they hit one. Drummond's got his second basket of the night.
pursues the offensive glass with purpose. Drummond knows who he is, and boy, does he attack him.
Back to Heald. The pass to Barnes. The wide open look here for Fox. Off target from three-point range. Lakers leading by five. Now Schroeder. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Driving the lane. Drummond. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
And so Fox will bring it up for the Kings. And there's the call on Andre Drummond. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Kings. Whiteside comes in for Rashawn Holmes. And it's DeLon Wright in for Halliburton. Outside. Outside, Fox.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Caruso looking for an opening. Fox with the steal. On the wing, Heald. Boy, he was something else against San Antonio. Whiteside, good.
Yeah, 7'1", and with the type of length that Whiteside has in terms of his vertical reach, so hard to stop on the inside.
Now here's Harrell. This all setting the pick for Harrell. Headshot off. Good D by Barnes. The Kings trailed by five. For the three. A putback. Whiteside. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. They get Marc Gasol.
Well, sometimes the D has no choice but to foul Whiteside and try to make him earn it.
What happens to team chemistry, Brent, at this stage of the season? Teammates have spent, you know, a lot of time together already at this point.
Well, this is where veteran leadership and guys who have been through deep runs or their understanding of what it takes to have a team go through deep runs can really pay off, Kevin. Making guys accountable to the things that you've talked about all year long in the next couple weeks, that's critical. Big hands, long arms, huge frame of Whiteside. It just makes him a dominant shot blocker, a huge rim protector, and a very good rebounder.
Here's what Sacramento's going with right now. Reese Harkless comes in for Buddy Heald, and it's Terrence Davis in for Fox. And both free throws good from Whiteside. Lakers leading by three. Caruso kicks to Matthews. Takes the three. A three-pointer is right on target.
And loving the hustle here early. I mean, they struck first on the offensive glass.
Wright, the pass to Whiteside. The kick out to Barnes. That one falls.
Look, I know everybody wants to play point guard, but when Whiteside starts to do it, look out.
1:41 left here in the first quarter. Horton Tucker, the pass to Harrell. There's the pick. To the wing right side. Offline with his three.
And that one gives them a plus five rebound advantage, Kevin.
Davis surveying the floor. Right outside. Six to shoot. The dish to Whiteside. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And that's what you want to do with Whiteside, feeding him the ball in the paint where he makes the defense collapse.
For Sacramento, they have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line.
And collectively, they're only about 73% as a unit right now.
That one is off. So he comes up empty at the line. Strange to see Marc Gasol shooting from outside. His game, Greg, wasn't always like it is now.
I mean, Gasol has added a three to his game in the last seasons with Memphis, and it was an immediate success. He became a functioning stretch five. Early in his career, he was more likely to drag you to the block and just bruise you more than anything else. Well, you know, teams look for plus sixes, players whose wingspans exceed their height by a half foot. Montrezl Harrell is a 6'7 player with a 7'4 wingspan. If you're struggling with the math, ladies and gentlemen, that's a plus 9.
That's good from Harrell.
The compliment that Harrell gets often is the fact that he's just so tireless a worker, and that energy is something that both coaching staffs and teammates appreciate.
No good on the second, so he hits one of two. The Kings trail by 5. On the wing, Barnes. There's 39 seconds left here in the opening quarter. He gets that one.
And using every bit of muscle he's got on that one, what can I say? Harrison Barnes likes to get in and attack.
Caruso, the pass to Harrell. It's not going to go for him. Good D by Barnes.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
Right side, inside. Working on Gasol. And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for one more.
All about positioning. Whiteside throws himself into the mix and comes away with the rebound.
Sacramento shooting their 5th attempt at the line in the game. One misses for Whiteside. Here's Horton Tucker. No points in the game yet for him. The tray. Oh, and he got it!
Did that beat the buzzer, Kevin?
Yes!
Wow.
Yes!
Ringing the bell. That's the way to close a quarter.
Well, you love nailing the last second shot. Always a feel-good moment.
The offense coming free and easy as we wrap up the first quarter. Lakers lead by 4, and we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And taking a look at the Lakers' performance here, what have they been doing or not doing in the game?
I mean, the rebounding was the difference in that first period. You've got to block these guys out.
Yeah, rebounding can also be just about will, and they showed some of that in going in there and collecting some boards.
And so here's Sacramento, trailing by 4. After this one, they're off to San Antonio to take on the Spurs. That'll be just one game played away from home for them. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Morris is out there with Kyle Kuzma. Then there's Dennis Schroeder. Then there's Andre Drummond. And it's Caldwell Pope in at the 2 spot. Holmes finds Fox. There's the drive.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Schroeder passes to Kuzma. Hit the putback. And Drummond is right there. Drummond's got the first points up on the board here in the second quarter for the Lakers.
Nice tip in there. I mean, he's got like a sixth sense in terms of where the miss is going to go. That is really a talent.
It's good from long range.
Yeah, watching Hield shoot is quite astonishing. He does a great job of establishing his feet as a foundation for his three-point shot.
Now, here's Schroeder. Had a 24-point outing in their last game against Orlando.
Well, what helps that out a lot is he got to the free throw line, which was a real game changer. It slowed down the opposition's momentum and made them play to his team style.
Here's Holmes after the made shot from Andre Drummond. And here's Halliburton. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. and it's sent back by Drummond.
A high motor keeps Drummond engaged defensively. He doesn't want to let any shots go in.
Schroeder kicks to Kuzma. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. An outstanding defensive play to earn the Mobile One block.
The defensive awareness, the timing, when you have to face a defender that can reject you like that, it can alter your approach.
And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter here. Schroeder with the ball. Pass to Kuzma. Drummond working against home. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. Around the free agent race last year, for your money, Greg, who would you have rather taken? Kawhi and PG, Kevin Durant and Kyrie.
Oof. Well, wow. I'll tell you what, it's a tough call. You know, Kawhi's got a couple finals MVPs. KD's got a couple. Kyrie's got a ring. It's a tough call. I mean, PG is more than capable, man. I think it's a toss-up, partner.
I agree. Yeah, I'm going to agree with you. Second free throw, no good.
Selected ninth overall in the 2012 draft, Drummond's carved out a nice NBA career for himself.
Now, here's Fox. Boy, that win the other night against the Spurs, another guy who really showed up to play.
And he waited for the last possible minute to get that one off, made a sick adjustment right before he let it go.
Here's Schroeder following the basket by Buddy Hield. Here's Drummond. Good for another bucket. He's made half a dozen now. 6 for 8 on the night.
Oh, man, this would be a different ball game if they didn't have this type of scoring to rely on.
Pass to Halibert. On the wing, heel. Just 5 to shoot. Pulls it up. Rebound, the Lakers. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Kings. That one was played in Sacramento.
Yeah, you saw the communication breakdowns defensively. Just giving up way too many open looks.
Yeah, sometimes you can play good on-ball defense, but it's the help defense that makes you elite. And on that night, nobody rotating and not a lot of help.
Here is Whiteside after the made shot from Dennis Schroeder. Whiteside, the pass to Holmes. Outside, Fox. Drives to the hoop. Scores for only the second time tonight. Now 2 for 6 from the field.
Well, this is when Fox is at his best. Once he gets a step on the defense, you're pretty much going to read the back of that jersey.
And De'Aaron Fox, one of those hyper-athletic point guards, but still more slight of build than a Westbrook or in their primes, John Wall, Derrick Rose. Do you think he needs to get stronger?
Well, I think that's a great question, and you could take it two ways. Yes, physically, and yes, mentally. I mean, he's getting a ton of minutes in the early part of his career, and De'Aaron Fox is learning how to be a better leader. So the answer, does he need to get stronger? He is.
Here's Schroeder after the basket by De'Aaron Fox.
A struggle for him tonight, but they can make this lead hold up. He can just chalk this up as one of those nights.
Now, here's Whiteside. He has 6. Here's Hield. Again, Sacramento. Now, here's Schroeder. And the Lakers decide to take their first time out here. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
Yeah, they really snuffed that one out. Didn't execute all that well. Fortunate to walk away with the W.
Yeah, we talk about gutsy wins, and on a night like that in the last game where they just did not shoot it well, that's a steal during a regular season.
the Kings will go for a different look here. Barnes, he's checked in for Whiteside. Harkless comes in for Buddy Hield. Terrence Davis, he's checked in for Halliburton. And it's DeLon Wright in for De'Aaron Fox. Now Harrell. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Orlando. Gasol, a screen on Barnes. Harrell drives in, and Harrell shoots it in.
Well, I think that Harrell lives and loves playing in traffic.
And so it's Wright bringing up the ball for Sacramento. It's a three-point game. Here's Holmes, and the layup's good off the glass. Holmes got his second bucket tonight.
And that's a lesson for the D. Fight harder on the glass.
Yeah, you just can't afford to give up second chance opportunities again and again.
Now here's Harrell. Here's Caruso. A three-pointer, no good. Wright looking around. Good ball movement here by the Kings. Barnes against Harrell. Rejected by Gasol. And here they come. Pass to Harrell. From the stripe. That one wide left.
D giving him that shot, and that's probably not a good idea, but I guess they knew what they were doing that time.
To the left side wing. Here's Holmes. The shot from the low post is good. Holmes got the lead up to one now for the Kings. Guys back and forth this first half.
And this could continue to go back and forth the entire way.
Here's Caruso. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Looking now at some numbers for De'Aaron Fox. And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for Sacramento.
That mid-range shot has been a weapon for them up to this point, fellas.
Take a break.
Another
Take
part
break.
Of the game tonight where they've Two been shots. Effective is to get points in the paint.
That free throw, no good. He hits the second from the line. Sacramento's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Here's Holmes, and Rashawn Holmes gets the whistle that time. That's his third foul of the game.
Yeah, looking up at the scoreboard, guys, that's his third foul, and his coach has to consider now sitting him down.
Los Angeles has gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Harrell against Barnes. Down low, shoots from the right block, and there's Gasol. That's good on the assist by Harrell. And the Lakers lead by two.
Given how crafty Gasol is, it's difficult trying to stick to him, especially in these screen and roll sets.
Now here's Barnes. 14 points from him the last game against the Spurs in San Antonio. This is his first chance at the line tonight.
And this season, he's maintained very good form at the line, shooting at about an 83% clip.
The first one falls.
You think about Harrison Barnes when he won an NBA championship in his third year in the league after being the seventh pick in the 2012 NBA draft.
Barnes hits them both. There's 21 seconds left to play in the first half. Here's Caruso. Inside. Here's Harrell. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Harrell's got four this quarter.
Harrell will do whatever it takes to grab some of those buckets down low.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Lakers ahead, up two. We'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, folks, welcome back. Ernie Johnson alongside the Jet. That's Kenny Smith. The Diesel, that's Shaquille O'Neal. A lot of big-time action so far in this one. It was Andre Drummond who got hot in the first. He had 14 points, 8 rebounds, and 1 block. What'd you think, Kenny, about what we saw from the Lakers?
A lot of their offense has come off the bench tonight, Ernie, and that's something every coach loves to get. The score would be a lot different if they hadn't gotten those points from the reserves.
Shaq, what's your take on Sacramento?
Well, it was an uneven first half in terms of defense. Look, they gave up a lot of good looks. Field goal percentage is over 50%. That's got to come down if they want to win this game.
That about wraps it up. Time now for the second half of the game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. Andre Drummond has been sensational.
Yeah, and early on, he has been feasting in the paint, and you have to think they're going to keep feeding the big fella.
Oh, man, pouring it on right now, and why wouldn't you?
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet.
We've got De'Aaron Fox.
Rashawn Holmes out there with Harrison Barnes. Then it's Heal. And it's Halliburton in at the two guard. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento.
Attacking is one thing, but body control another. And Harrison Barnes showing you that on that play.
Well, Harrison Barnes at 6'8", 225 has played some power forward. Greg, do you like him there or at his more natural small forward position?
I think in today's game, Kevin, having the strength he does allows him to kind of hold his own. You know, you don't see a lot of four men playing a lot of post up in today's game. He's still got to be able to play in space, and I think creates matchup nightmares for the opponent.
Here's Barnes after the made shot from Andre Drummond. And here's Halliburton. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. The quick crossover, what a move.
And guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
Schroeder with the ball. Drummond with a screen on Fox. The drive by Schroeder. Count the basket and the foul. It's going to go on Rashawn Holmes. Greg, we have a league of many great playmakers, don't we?
Oh, there's no doubt about it. LeBron James is obvious. You know, he played point guard technically for the first time last season, but he's always been a floor general. You look at a young man like Ja Morant, and he's been on the attack since day one when he hit the league. And there's so many more of those guys that are having an impact, understanding the value of that lead guard position. It is fun to watch.
It is so fun to watch. I agree.
The potential Schroeder has is pretty exciting. Such a lightning quick point guard.
Schroeder against Heald from downtown. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Morris has got rebound number 5 here tonight. Now here's Schroeder. There's the pass to Kuzma. Fires for 3. Here's Drummond. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass. And now a 4-point Laker lead. Fox deciding where to go with it. Passes it to Halliburton. On the wing, Heal. Rebound Andre Drummond. Drummond's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Kuzma outside. There's the triple. And Drummond throws it down.
And this is who Drummond can be, an offensive anchor who can dominate once he gets cooking.
The Kings trail by six.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Halliburton, that's good.
Yeah, here's a list of things I don't want to do, and right at the top is guard that guy.
Fox against Schroeder. Here he goes. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
The Lakers have had an off night from the stripe tonight.
And taking a look at their free throw statistics on the season, right around 74%.
Whiteside's checked in for Rashawn Holmes. That one misses for Schroeder.
If you told me this was the kind of game he was going to have, I would not have expected them to be in front right now.
On the wing, Barnes. Now Heal. 10 points for him. Shot clock at six. No good from 18.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
Third quarter action, and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Nobody near Schroeder. They get it back. Drummond battles through traffic and lays it in. Drummond's got 8 here in the quarter.
Continuing to show activity on the offensive glass. Second chance buckets have been huge.
Pass to Heal. Fires from 14. A rebound by the Lakers. Drummond's Los Angeles leading by 8. Stolen away. Takes it inside. Whiteside trying to break free. They get it again. Shot by Heald. Nobody around. Again, Heald missing.
Yeah, the defense there in chill mode. We all know he can burn them from three-point range.
Schroeder kicks to Kuzma. Jacks up a three. And it's Fox with the rebound.
Yeah, he's not very hard to defend right now. This is when the defense might step back and let him try to find his range.
To the paint. Here's Barnes. That one a little long. And here's Caldwell Pope. He brings it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half.
Well, Schroeder likes to drive first, now establishing the shoot-first confidence. Love watching him rise up immediately after the catch.
Now, here's Fox. He has 6. Some nice ball movement here by the Kings. Heald, the pass to Whiteside. Can they get it? And it's good on the way in. Whiteside's got 8.
Well, Heald right there on the yield, waiting for someone to get open.
Lakers leading by 9, and the Lakers call time here.
Well, Buddy Heald, the consummate gym rat, growing up in the Bahamas, he built his own rim with a milk crate and would shoot all night. His neighbors got so tired of yelling at him to keep it down, he sprinkled broken glass under the rim to get him to move the hoop.
Some changes for Sacramento. Maurice Harkless is checked in for Harrison Barnes. Davis comes in for Halliburton, and it's Wright in for De'Aaron Fox. Here's Caruso. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game.
And stolen by Wright.
The putback. It's good on the putback. And that's a double-double for him now. 10 points and 10 rebounds.
Now here's a memo. You have to box out Whiteside or he'll burn you with the putback jam.
Here's Gasol. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Here's a look at which players have been the most adept at finding and hitting high percentage shots since the All-Star break. The fourth spot held by Montrezl Harrell.
His touch around the bucket has been outstanding. I mean, he has missed very few of the good looks he's gotten.
And he makes the first.
And you have to have appreciation for how Gasol does everything well. Polished scorer, skilled rebounder, solid passer, and the man defends.
And so Gasol nails them both. A lot of talk about receding in the playoffs when you got down to the final four teams. If it ensures the two best teams make the finals, it would seem to me, Greg, to be worth it. What about you?
You know, it could be. I think about the worldwide attention on that championship round, but you got to get the Eastern Conference teams to sign off on that. And, you know, we've seen it happen in the past where the power shifts from one conference to the other. But ultimately, nothing better than seeing the two best teams play for it all.
Now, here's Matthews. Good on the bucket. Matthews has got the lead up to 11 now for the Lakers.
Well, that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense, a quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in.
.122 left in the third quarter. Healed, can't hit.
No other way to put it. Just a rough quarter in terms of scoring. He has not been helping at all.
Pass to Caruso. Gasol setting the pick for Harrell from 12 feet out. And it's Hassan Whiteside with the rebound. Whiteside's got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. Back to Wright. Now the pass to Davis. Shoots from 12. Healed, can't hit.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
Now, here's Gasol, and it's Sacramento with the rebound. Whiteside's got rebound number 13 for him here tonight. There's 18 seconds left to play in the third. And the jam by Whiteside.
And a nice show of strength from Whiteside there. Slapped on the shot, but still makes the basket.
For Sacramento, they have missed a few free throws up to this point, shooting 4-7 from the foul line tonight.
What's up?
Free throw, good, Whiteside. And so it's the Lakers with it. And here's Schroeder. And Whiteside sends it back.
And you consider just how long and how big Whiteside.
Oh, and he beat it.
Did they just do that, Kevin?
They just did that.
Wow, what a way to finish up the quarter.
That's an incredible shot. They just let it fly, take a chance, and somehow that one goes in.
Andre Drummond has been on display for Los Angeles. He made his mark in a big way on the boards in that quarter. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with his feet. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
And that's what great passing will do for you right there, dissecting the defense with that play.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. So for the Lakers right now, Montrezl Harrell is out there with Morris. Then it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Then there's Dennis Schroeder. And it's Kuzma in at the small forward. Fox kicks to Whiteside. Back to Fox. And there's the drive. Holmes passes to Fox. And he uses the glass on the layup.
Pretty much all you can do on defense there. De'Aaron Fox, great poise in the painted area.
Los Angeles leading by six. Schroeder with the ball. And it's blocked by Whiteside. Here's Halliburton. Good. Nice job down low.
And great intensity here down the stretch. He's not one to shrink in the moment.
Take a look at him. Locked in right now in this moment. Wants the ball in his hands and feels real comfortable with the shot he's taking.
And he just dangles from the bucket after sending that one through.
And you can see which team has the swagger right now. Now, here's Whiteside. Sacramento moving it around. Fox passes to Holmes. Back to Fox. Good. Fox has got 4 points this quarter.
Well, hard to get Fox off of his center of gravity. So low, so quick, and phenomenal at scoring when he gets hit.
Kuzma outside. Three-pointer. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder.
And certainly they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
Fox finds Whiteside. Now, here is Halliburton. Outside, Fox. And the shot goes in.
Pretty good. The dribble set that up, got some space, and then knocked it down.
Los Angeles leading by five. Schroeder passes to Morris. Now, here's Harrell, guarded by Holmes. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. It's going to go on Rashawn Holmes.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
And he can't get the first one.
And they're having a lot of trouble at the line today. And unfortunately, it's the kind of day we've seen this team have a lot.
The Kings making a switch here. Heald's checked in. Good on the second free throw. Here's Halliburton. On the wing, Heal. Doesn't go that time. And the Lakers going the other way now. They've led by as many as 11 points. Schroeder outside. Passes it to Harrell. Lock at six. Shoots over Holmes. And no good. Trying to use the glass. The Kings trail by six. Pass to Heald. And here is Holmes, covered by Morris. Holmes can't get it to go in.
Yeah, my expectations were that he was not going to miss that one. He handles that kind of defense, especially on the inside.
Basket, good.
All heart from Caldwell Pope there, using every ounce of strength to muscle that shot in.
Here's Fox, following the basket by Kentavious Caldwell Pope. Heald outside. Pass to Halliburton. Lets it go from deep. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Halliburton's got 9 points here in the second half.
Los Angeles leading by five. Schroeder outside.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
The Kings have gone 5 of 8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. Fox passes to Halliburton. Outside, Fox. A three ball and another three for Sacramento.
Continuing to expand his offensive game. Fox off to a good start.
And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. Shoots over Fox. Here's Harrell, and Harrell slams it in.
That's going to be a big morale booster.
And you know what? It could come down to those second chance buckets when it's all said and done today.
Well, especially in a close game, every possession matters.
And Sacramento has possession. Following the bucket by the Lakers, and it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. The Lakers making a switch here. Drummond's checked in. And a chance there to look back at the stunning Mobile One block a moment ago.
And guys, that's about as good a defensive play as you'll see. Instant reaction to get a hand to the shot.
Here's Fox. Now here's Barnes. Kuzma pulls it in. Schroeder surveying the floor. The three, and he's good on the three ball. Schroeder's got 5 points now this quarter.
Well, not known as an outside Schroeder, he's definitely working on his three-point accuracy.
Now Heal. Going inside, and it's sent back by Morris. And they'll keep possession. And here comes the break. For three, Caldwell-Pope. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Here's Heald. They get a hand on it. Now the Lakers on the break. Schroeder leading the charge, but they recover it.
Yeah, maybe a little luck, maybe a little bit of heart. Both of those at play here. He's getting every offensive rebound.
Six to shoot. Drummond trying to get himself free. That's good from Schroeder on the assist by Caldwell-Pope.
I have to credit to D at least for contesting that one. Ultimately, Schroeder is just too good from that range. Can't let him get the ball there.
Holmes with a screen on Kuzma. Heald can't hit.
Not a way to get out of a funk. He needs to be looking for good, solid, more efficient shots. Not the wild one he took there.
And it's in there. And now it's an 11-point Laker lead.
And even though Schroeder might be on the light end of things when it comes to his weight, he remains relentless driving towards the basket.
Holmes with a screen on Kuzma. Heald can't hit.
Just not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far just not himself in the second half.
Back to Kuzma. Inside, Drummond. And Drummond throws it down.
And these are the types of games where one team clearly has the edge. Tonight, it will be a win by a large margin for the Lakers.
What do you think was the deciding factor in this one?
I think you have to look at their field goal percentage. They just shot the ball much better than the opponent, and they were getting great looks all game long.
And so taking a look at their season record, this will be win number 31 on the year.
And with this win now, we're all square, 1-1. Two more games yet to come in what's proving to be a very competitive season series.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Drummond.
I liked his aggressiveness here tonight, especially on the glass. He was not messing around.
And now, let's present our New Balance Player of the Game, Andre Drummond.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good look for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. That has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
I don't think anyone in this building saw this coming. I'm sure that of the players who these fans thought would beat them, his name was not at the top of the list.
And with the monster finish, he stops an 11-0 run by Los Angeles.
Schroeder against Fox. The drive by Schroeder. And they immediately answer back with the dunk at the other end.
Making every effort to put this game on ice.
Loved it. The guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
Now here's Schroeder after the miss from Buddy Hield. Schroeder kicks to Kuzma. Schroeder with a screen on Hield. Kuzma inside, covered by Hield. And it's Barnes with the ball for the Sacramento Kings, trailing by 13. Again, Hield missing. Schroeder, left side. And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And we'll see you next time.